Where there is sufficient moisture available, the cultivator point choice should be optimized for the root development of the crop, as well as the amount of crop residues in the field. However, since the weather commonly changes between years, access to water is often the most limiting factor for the development of a crop, both in years when it's really dry and really wet. Both weather scenarios need to be considered when choosing the optimal point on a tine cultivator. The following applies to medium to heavy soil conditions. The lighter, self-compacting soils poses different challenges and is not addressed in this movie. Let's start by looking at years with dry weather conditions. If it is a dry year, it makes sense to work with a thinner point. This way, we disturb the soil to a minimum, so it stays more intact below and can transport ground moisture upwards, closer to the surface by capillarity. And to compensate for its lower mixing ability, the thin point can be combined with a wider shin. Looking at the year where we can expect wet weather conditions, the thin point also offers benefits. In this aspect, the cultivation bottom created by the point instead serves the purpose of making thin craters where water can be collected. This will build up pressure and efficiently drain the field. And if there is plenty of water expected, such as when cultivating before winter, you can use a breaking point. That way, you make the water pillar build up even faster. And if the conditions are close to the limit, try to work more shallow than usual and work your way downwards in steps. Choosing a thinner point to handle wet or dry weather conditions will limit the mixing ability of the cultivator. This can be compensated by an intensified shallow mixing through discs in the same tool or by using a point that both breaks the soil below and mixes it on the top.